Here we'll consider a policy mix. So policy mix means what? The combination of both fiscal and monetary policy. So let us take an example in which, in one hand, the government is reducing public expenditure, and that public expenditure is financed by increasing the money supply, maybe printing new money, so which we call the deficit financing. So in one hand, government is increasing the money supply, increasing the public expenditure. On the other hand, government is increasing the money supply. So how the mechanism will work? Initially, whenever the government increases the money supply, that means definitely the aggregate demand and level of output will increase. If aggregate demand increases, that means demand for money will also increase. So there will be an excess demand situation in the money market. But on the other hand, whenever the government is increasing the money supply, this will somehow dampen the excess demand in the money market. And consequently, the rate of interest will rise, definitely rise. But in case of if the government expenditure is not supported by increase in money supply, there will be high increase in rate of interest. But here, increase in government public expenditure is being supported by money supply. So the effect of excess demand will be dampened. That means there will be less increase in the rate of interest, and consequently there will be less volume of crowding out effect here. So now we can show it with the help of a diagram first. In horizontal axis we are measuring output and aggregate demand. In vertical axis we are measuring the rate of interest. So this is our ice curve and this is our LM curve. So initially there is an increase in public expenditure. So new ice curve is I1 S1. So what we see? So if there is absence of the increase in money supply, we know that economy will reach its final equilibrium at this is E0 at point E dash. But here what we consider? Here we consider that government is also increasing the money supply. So there will be rightward shift of the LM curve from L0 M0 to L1 M1. So without any increase in money supply, the crowding out effect would be represented by that Y dash to Y star. But here what we find that the ultimate equilibrium will be determined by the intersection of I1S1 and L1M1. So my final equilibrium will be Y1R1 and Y1. So here what we see? Here we see that due to increasing money supply, that means due to deficit financing, there will be a less increase in rate of interest, and now this is the volume of crowding out. So in this case, the fiscal effectiveness of fiscal policy will increase by the support of expansionary monetary policy. Now we will prove it mathematically. First, the commodity market equilibrium condition, Y equals to A plus BY plus IR plus G. We know that this is the meaning of B and this is the I dash will be negative. So we name it equation 1. So if we differentiate equation 1, what I will get? Dy equals to B into BG. So we can write dy minus b dy minus I dash dr equals to dg, or dy into 1 minus b minus I dash dr equals to dg. So I give it name equation 1a. Now let us consider the money market equilibrium condition. Ky plus Lr equals to M1 by P. So if we differentiate it, we get K dash dy plus L dash dr equals to d of M1 by P. So here we can also write that K dash is greater than 0 by the property and L dash is less than 0. So this was equation number 2, we get it 2a. And here our first assumption is that dg equals to d m bar by p. So we can replace dm bar by p by dg. And now equation 1a and 2a we can set it into a matrix multiplication form. So the matrix multiplication form we can write 1 minus b minus I dash k dash l dash equals to dg and dg. So Cramer's rule can be applied. Why we are using dg? Because we have already considered, as per the assumption, the change in money supply will be exactly equal to the change in public expenditure. So this equation can be solved if we say that delta equals to 1 minus b, the value of the matrix, to be precise, coefficient matrix, not equals to 0, that equals to L dash to 1 minus b plus I dash into k dash. So L dash positive, 1, L dash negative, 1 minus b positive, I dash negative, k dash positive. So this is less than 0, that means not equal to 0. The metric, the we can use the Cramer's rule. So by Cramer's rule we can write that dy, sorry, it must be a minor mistake here, it will be dy dr equals to dg dg. So that means it can be solved if dy equals to 1 by delta multiplied by dg dg minus I dash L dash. So dy equals to L dash into 1 minus b plus I dash k dash, and the numerator will be now L dash into dg plus I dash into dg. So dg to I dash plus L dash divided by L dash into 1 minus B plus I dash K dash. So by cross multiplication we can write here that dy by dg equals to I dash plus K dash whole divided by L dash into 1, sorry, it will be numerator, it will be L dash plus I dash into L dash into 1 minus B plus I dash K dash. So if we break it, we will get 1 divided by 1 plus B plus I dash K dash by L dash plus 1 divided by L dash by I dash into 1 minus B plus K dash. So here numerator denominator is greater than 0, here also denominator is greater than 0. So dy by dg, that means the value of public expenditure multiplier during in case of deficit financing will be equal to 1 divided by 1 minus b plus I dash k dash by l dash. So this is the case of the normal public expenditure multiplier. And we have another additional part, that is l dash by I dash into 1 minus b plus k dash. So in this case the multiplier value will be greater than normal money, normal government expenditure multiplier. So from here we can conclude that if the increase in public expenditure is financed by increase in money supply, there will be definitely an increase in the value of the multiplier. So in this case, public government change in public expenditure will be more effective.